The medications that we use for the treatment of ADHD are described as stimulant medications. One of the concerns that has been expressed by parents, but also by clinicians, is the extent to which many of these drugs are abused in order to prepare for exams. Stimulant abuse actually among high school students is quite prevalent, and it's estimated that approximately 8% of 12th graders have abused an amphetamine-like compound drug in the past year. There has been the belief that they are safe, that they improve cognition, and that they actually increases your chances of getting better performance in education. But what the data is showing us is that overall stimulant medications do not improve your cognitive performance. If you have someone that is performing optimally and you give them a stimulant, their performance may deteriorate. The important question is, does it have negative effects? That is to say, is the use of stimulant medications in a kid that doesn't have ADHD potentially negative or deleterious? If you're giving stimulant medications to a kid that doesn't have ADHD, at a time in their life when their brain is developing very rapidly, that may interfere with those developmental processes. When someone is abusing stimulants, the effects can be not very dissimilar to those that you observe with cocaine or methamphetamine. All of these are stimulant drugs. When you are dealing with adolescents, which is the period of higher risk, that's why you have to be particularly careful, because even though they may not have the genetic vulnerability, they're at a stage in their life where exposure to drugs can create changes in the brain that may result in addictive behaviors. It can produce full-blown psychosis. So you can end up in an emergency room because you are basically completely paranoid. It can be very severe and devastating to the person. There are many misconceptions about what stimulants do and don't do. And as a result of this misconception, teenagers and college students are much more likely to take them. It does have deleterious effects. And so that is where the distorted beliefs can lead someone to take a drug that if they knew better, they wouldn't take it.